So my grandfather was a coal miner in River Hebert, and he was born in 1900, actually. And in 1913, he went down into the mines for the first time when he was 13 years old. And in River Hebert, is anybody here from Cumberland County? Where are you from?
Oxford.
Oh, well, there you go. I'm from Amherst, right? So my mother is from River Hebert.
Born in Amherst.
My grandfather was born in Macan. My dad was born in Bathurst, so he was the French guy that came down and stole the girl kind of thing. But my mother was from a big mining family, and my grandfather worked in the Cumberland Mines in River Hebert and Joggins. And I remember when I was a kid, Grampy wasn't in the mines by then, but my uncles were. And we used to go, in the summer, we'd go and pick up the miners, and they'd come up this huge long shaft in the back of these old carts, and then they'd get in the trunk of the car and come home, and they'd have to shower off with a hose outside the house. Nobody would let them ride inside the cars. I don't know what they did in the winter, but they
she
would
knows
just...
exactly
they,
what you're talking about. She's nodding along with every bit of that.
They would literally just open the trunk, and four men would sit in the back of these great big old, you know, Pontiac, whatever, and they'd drive them home, and they'd drop them off up Beach Hill. My grandparents lived up on Beach Hill. Anyway, this is a song about one time when my grandfather was involved, just one time he was involved in a cave-in. By the time I knew Grampy, he only had like three fingers on this hand and four fingers on this hand, and both of his eardrums were gone, because his main job, his promotion, was to plant the dynamite and then get out, while somebody called the shot fire would set it off. So usually the shot fire was really good about making sure everybody was out, but this one time he wasn't. I'm just going to tell a little bit more about this story. Sorry, guys. So this particular time, my mother tells me that my grandparents had this huge fight before Grampy went to work. Yeah, well, I've never really told the whole story, right? So they had this. So when this happened, you can sort of imagine my grandmother's reaction. Anyway, you'll hear the story and what happens. But my grandmother was a tough woman. She was a coal mining wife, and she raised coal mining sons, and she had a coal mining husband. She was one tough woman. Never swore. I never heard her swear or take a drink or smoke a cigarette. But man, she was one tough woman. This is called We Were Miners Then.
Well, here I
ground. In 10 cents a ton was all they paid for the rock that Grampy Duck died.
I know I told you 45 minutes, but we're not done playing yet. Couple more. Do we take requests? What kind of question is that? You know full well if you want a request, you have to write it down on a piece of paper on the opposite side of the portrait of the Queen. But seeing as a Jew, I think we might be able to get it.
Made the man for Richmond and Fed. It was a time I remember.
Thank you.
That's what your grandmother asked for.
Sunny stream.
Yes. I have.